Today we're going to take a closer look at why earthquakes and volcanoes are constantly occurring on Earth, and learn more about how our planet is always changing. How are mountains, oceans, and continents created? And what do earthquakes fight over? Stick around to find out!
In order to answer these important questions, it starts with one of the most important scientific discoveries of all time, the theory of plate tectonics. The theory of plate tectonics states that the Earth's solid outer crust, the lithosphere, is separated into many plates that move over the asthenosphere, the molten upper portion of the mantle. Oceanic and continental plates come together, spread apart, and interact at plate boundaries all over the planet. The lithosphere is the rigid, rocky outer part of Earth, consisting of the crust that we live on and the upper mantle. The lithosphere is made up of approximately 7 major tectonic plates and many other minor or smaller ones. These plates interact with one another in 3 different ways: transform boundaries, divergent boundaries, and convergent boundaries. Essentially, where plates meet on Earth's crust, they slide, divide, and collide. And this is where the majority of geologic activities on Earth occur, including earthquakes and volcanoes. Plate boundaries are the location of many of the most tremendous landforms found on our planet. Many of the geologic activities we experience on Earth's surface and the remarkable landforms we admire are greatly determined on the types of crust that are interacting along plate boundaries. And if the crust plates are sliding along one another, dividing, or colliding. Let's take a closer look at what's happening. 2 oceanic plates are pulled apart. Magma rises to fill the gap, creating small volcanoes underwater. An incredible example is the Mid-Atlantic Ridge. You can see here that the Atlantic Ocean is just being pulled apart over millions and billions of years, making Africa and South America separate, creating new crusts at the bottom of the ocean. 2 continental plates move apart. Fracture forms in the rock. The land between the fault slips down. As the continents continue to move apart, lakes fill the gap. Then a sea, and eventually an ocean. An incredible example is the Great African Rift Valley. You can see Africa is being pulled apart from the Middle East, Saudi Arabia here, causing the Red Sea to get greater and greater. Oceanic and continental crust collide. More dense oceanic crust sinks and melts. Magma rises and creates volcanoes. A tremendous example of this is this tiny oceanic crust here is being subducted underneath the western part of the United States. As the magma rises underneath the continental crust, it creates this chain or volcanic arc of volcanoes along the western coast of the United States, including Mount St. Helens, one of the most famous and explosive eruptions that ever occurred in recorded history. 2 oceanic plates collide. Older plate sinks, creating a deep spot in the ocean called a trench. As the plate melts, magma rises, creating a volcanic island. An incredible example of this is the Marianas Trench, where this oceanic plate is being subducted underneath this younger oceanic plate, creating this deep trench here, the deepest trench in the world. It's also creating chains and chains of islands. You can see all of these islands are a volcanic arc of islands, including Japan and the Philippines and Guam. All of these islands were created by subduction. 2 continental crusts collide. Neither subducts because neither is more dense, and the rock pushes up, creating some of the tallest mountains in the world, including Mount Everest in the Himalayas in Asia. 2 plates slide past each other in the opposite direction. Pressure builds up and eventually releases, This can happen on land or underwater at mid-ocean ridges. One of the most famous examples is the San Andreas Fault in California, where the Pacific plate is sliding in the opposite direction as the North American plate, causing tremendous earthquakes to occur in California. So let's practice. Which of the following best explains the formation of these islands and the Aleutian Trench located along the North American plate in Alaska? This would be a good time to pause. If you picked A, you are correct. Volcanoes form an island arc, indicating a convergent boundary. Here you can see this volcanic island arc is created as this Pacific plate is being subducted underneath this oceanic plate. And as the magma rises, it's creating this whole volcanic arc of islands and this deep sea trench. Here's a fantastic chart summarizing what we learned. Feel free to pause and review. So what do earthquakes fight over? Whose fault it was? If you had to live directly on a plate boundary, which plate boundary would you rather live on? A convergent, divergent, or transform plate boundary? Explain why. Leave a comment below. I hope this video was helpful. Thanks for watching.